All right, y'all. We're jumping in the time machine and we're going back. Going back to Nas, Illmatic. An album that is almost, not quite, but almost 30 years old. We're nearing the end of 21. This was made in 94. Almost. I reckon, based off of every now and then I look at the analytics for my YouTube channel, it shows me all kinds of stuff. But based off of the audience that I have, my subscribers, I would wager that this album is older than a lot of you. this one's come up not as often as I think it should have come up. Someone pointed out to me, I don't know, a month ago or so, maybe not that long. Nice write-up, I think it was on Patreon, this message, and just talking about how a lot of the requests I've been getting are more recent work, probably from a somewhat younger audience, and he said, you got to go back. You got to go way back and get into some of the heart of hip hop. And I totally agree. You know, kind of starting this channel, just going off of what people are saying and listening to whatever comes up. And I'm open to all of those things. But there is a big part of me that wants to go back and get into the roots of where hip hop kind of came from. I think Illmatic does that based off of what I've heard. I've never heard anything from Wu-Tang. I would love to do some Wu-Tang. I still have this idea. I want to do a revisit on Black Sunday by Cypress Hill because that was an album a buddy of mine used to listen to all the time when I was a kid. And so I'm familiar with it, but it's been so long since I've heard it. I think it'd be fun to listen to again. But, you know, Illmatic, some of the Tupac stuff, Biggie Smalls I've never listened to. Like, there's all these old school guys that I've never heard. And really, they haven't been recommended that much. So I'm excited to get into this one. It's a very highly regarded album, over 25 years old. I have not been told a lot as far as what it's about, which is kind of nice in a way. You know, I enjoy going in blind and jumping in. And that's what this experience is going to be. I guess I don't have too much else to say about it. I can just start playing the music, I suppose. This came out in 94. I was in high school. I was just starting high school in 94. There's a chance I may have heard some of this music. To my knowledge, I've never heard Nas. I've never heard this. But, you know, radio was big back then. That was a lot of how you heard music was on the radio. And I had to ride the bus back then. And so they always listened to the same radio station. It was hip hop and pop and whatever. And possible I've heard some of these. Anyway, here we go. Illmatic, first time listen, never heard it as far as I know. Nas, we're gonna kick off track one, Genesis.
And you're sitting at home doing this shit? And you should be honoring a medal for this. Stop fucking around and be a man. There ain't nothing out here for you. Oh, yes, there is.
I already like in the background that like kind of old school beat. I'm really interested to see how comfortable I am listening to this because some of it, you know, the other day I was watching Straight Outta Compton and it's a fun movie to watch. But hearing some of those songs again and go, oh yeah, that's why I want to do Black Sunday again too because I think it would just be a mind fuck to listen to it again.
This. Yo, Nas, yo, what the fuck is this bullshit on the radio, son? Chill, chill, that's the shit, girl, chill.
Hey, yo, yo, pull out and shave, man, let's count this money, nigga. Hey, yo, Nas, put the jack from the grass over there, you
good
know what I'm
saying? Good fat right. Baseline, man.
You know how we get down, baby.
True, Nas, yo, Nas, man, shit is mad real right now. The project's for a nigga, yo, where the mother? All them crab-ass rappers coming up to me, man, where the mother, man? I think you need to let them niggas know it's real, man.
True indeed, you know what I'm saying? But when it's real, you doing this even without a record contract, you know what I'm saying?
No question.
You doing this since back then.
I'm saying, regardless how I go down, we gon' keep it real. We no try to see many matches and coops, kid.
True, yo, you know man. How that go? Where's Grand Wizard and Mayo at, man?
Yo, about the Phillies. Take this Hennessy, man.
What is this? The Grand Wizard and Mayo. What is that? Oh, okay. Grand Wizard is his cousin. Who's Mayo? Close friends. Okay. Grand Wizard makes me think of something else. Like, whoa, hold on. We're jumping in already. We're jumping in deep.
Come on, man. Stop waving that, man. Come on, that is.
Take this Hennessy, man. Like the Phillies up, man. Nigga, stop fucking burning Phillies, man.
Fat
It's got, I mean, it's almost got like a lo-fi quality to it, doesn't it?
I'm saying no, man.
But I think that this is just supposed to be an opening track. It's only at 1:45, so.
Representing is Illmatic.
Yeah, here we go. Okay. Track 2, NY, State of Mind.
Yo, Black, it's time, Bird is timing. It's time, man. Alright, begin. Yeah, straight out the fucking dungeons of rap, where fake niggas don't make it back. I don't know how to start this. Rappers are monkey flipping with the funky rhythm. I be kicking, musician, inflicting composition of pain. I'm like Scarface sniffing cocaine, holding an M16. See, with the pen, I'm extreme. Now, bullet holes left in my peepholes. I'm suited up with street clothes. Hand me a 9 and out the beat flows. Y'all know my steelo, with or without the airplay. I keep some E and J, sitting bent up in the stairway. Or either on the corner, betting grants with the CeeLo champs. Laughing at bass heads, trying to sell some broken amps. G-packs get off quick forever. My niggas talk shit, reminiscing about the last time the task force flipped. Niggas be running through the block shooting. Time to start the revolution. Catch a body head for Houston. Once they caught us off guard, the Mac-10 was in the grass. And I ran like a cheetah with thoughts of an assassin. Picked the Mac up, told brothers back up. The Mac spit, lead was hitting niggas. One ran, I made a backflip. Heard a few chicks scream, my arm shook. Couldn't look, gave another squeeze. Heard it click, yo, my shit is stuck. Tried to cock it, it wouldn't shoot. Now I'm in danger. Finally pulled it back and saw 3 bullets caught up in the chamber. So now I'm jetting to the building lobby. And it was full of children, probably couldn't see as high as I be. It's like the game.
I really want to let this whole verse play out, but it looks like it's going to go for a while. I'm already noticing, I'm trying to place my mind into, you know, back then. And some of the stuff that was big back then, I don't know exactly the time frames, but I know Chronic was big back then. You know, Snoop Dogg, Ice Cube, Biggie. Now, Biggie Smalls was Notorious B.I.G., right? Right? I think so. Like, that was the album. I think that was the album. And Biggie Smalls was the rapper, I think. Tupac. Already, man, already I can just hear kind of that old school, what do they call it, gangster rap sound. It's got a great little bass, you know. And it's interesting to listen to it now and hear this now after hearing fucking Death Grips, after hearing Yeezus, after hearing Tyler, the Creator. Like, it's cool. It is kind of a time machine, man. I mean, I was kind of joking around before, but it does, like, yeah, we're back. We're back in kind of the beginning. And this is, I mean, I like the just real straightforward, simple. It's simple. Kind of in today's terms, when you compare it to today's terms. But I like just, you know, he's telling a story about what's going on here, and it's just a good solid beat and good solid rhythm and rhymes and going through. So this is neat. I'm already enjoying this pretty much. Let me back it up a little bit. We'll pick it up again.
My shit is stuck. Tried to cock it. It wouldn't shoot. Now I'm in danger. Finally pulled it back and saw 3 bullets caught up in the chamber. So now I'm jetting to the building lobby. And it was full of children. Probably couldn't see as high as I be. It's like the game ain't the same. Got younger niggas pulling the triggers. Bringing fame to their name and claim some corners. Crews without guns or corners. In broad daylight. Stick up kids. They run up on us. 4-5s and gauges. Max and fat. Same niggas that catch you back to back. Catching your cracks in black. There was a snitch on the block getting niggas knocked. So hold your stash to the coke price drop. I know this crackhead who says you gotta smoke nice rock. And if it's good, you bring your customers and measuring plots. But yo, you gotta slide on a vacation. Inside information keeps large niggas erasing and they wild spacing. It drops deep as it does in my breath. I never sleep, cause sleep is the cousin of death. Beyond the walls of intelligence, life is defined. I think of crime when I'm in a New York state of mind. State of mind.
That's pretty wild. One thing, another thing I wanted to say, but I didn't want to pause it again during the verse, was also his voice. Even his voice in the style that he's using with his lyrics, kind of, it just brings me back to some of the old school stuff. Now, what I was thinking here, he's got this whole verse, talking about all the shit that they do. And that's essentially the summary for his New York state of mind. And it's kind of an interesting verse to hear and consider in contrast to Kendrick Lamar and Good Kid, Mad City, where in that album, Kendrick is kind of the antithesis of that, where he's trying to avoid that. Where here, Nas, either himself or the character who was in this album, I think in the gangster rap stuff, they're pretty much singing about themselves, or at least the stuff that they saw around them. He is the Mad City, you know, he's in that state of mind. He's doing all this crazy shit with, you know, guns and drugs and money and all this stuff. So it's an interesting contrast. I immediately started thinking of Good Kid, Mad City, and how these are like two sides of the same coin. Let's keep going. This is neat. This is fun. I'm glad I'm doing this one already. Life is defined. I think of crime when I'm in a New York state of mind. State of mind. Your state of mind. It's so cool, the beat, man. I mean, it's just simple and clean. But, I mean, it's just good hip hop. Drinking Moet, holding text, making sure the cash came correct. Then I step, investments and stock, sewing up the box to sell rocks. Winning gunfights with mega cops, but just a nigga walking with his finger on the trigger. Make enough figures until my pockets get bigger. I ain't the type of brother made for you to start testing. Give me a Smith and Wesson, I have niggas undressing. Thinking of cash flow, food and shelter. Whenever frustrated, I'm a hijack Delta. And the PJs, my blend tape plays, bullets are strays. Young bitches is braids, each block. It's like a maze full of black rats trapped. Plus the album is packed. From what I hear in all the stories, when my peoples come back black, I'm living where the nights is jet black. The fiends fight to get crack. I just max. I dream I could sit back and lamp like Capone. With drug strips on, all the legal luxury life. Rings flooded with stones, homes. I got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too sane. Life is parallel to hell, but I must maintain it. I don't want to pause in the middle of the verse, but he has long verses. I want to go back to each block is like a maze full of black rats trapped. Plus the island is packed from what I hear in all the stories when my peoples come back. This is really makes me want to know more. Rikers Island is the island. Oh, a major prison. Oh, plus the island is, okay, that's what he means there. Rikers Island, a prison, is packed. From what I hear in all the stories when my peoples come back. So the people who get out of prison. Interesting. Really interesting. I like this line about give me a Smith & Wesson and I'll have people undressing. You're just going to fucking rob them until they're naked. Oh, shit. This is great so far. I mean, great, solid beat. Good rhythm. I mean, good vocals, good rhythm. I mean, everything is just very easy to just head nod to. I got so many rhymes, I don't think I'm too sane. Life is parallel to hell, but I must maintain it be prosperous. Though we live dangerous, cops could just arrest me. Blaming us for hell like hostages. It's only right that I was born to use mics. And the stuff that I write is even tougher than dice. I'm taking rappers to a new plateau. Through rap slow, my rhyming is a vitamin. Hell without a capsule. The smooth criminal on beat breaks. Never put me in your box if your shit eats tape. The city never sleeps. Full of villains and creeps. That's where I learned to do my hustle. Had to scuffle with freaks. So this is a reference I actually understand. And some of you might be too young to understand, which is nice. I can pull one on you finally. Never put me in your box if your shit eats tape. So back then we had to listen to either the cassette tapes. Only the fancy kids had the CDs. Oh, fancy. And the cassette players, when they'd start fucking up, they would just pull all the tape out of the cassette and ruin the fucking cassette. Sometimes you could wind it back in, like you get a pencil and wind that shit back in. But if the tape deck was messed up, it would eat the tape. So never put me in your box if your shit eats tapes. That means don't play my music in your fucking shitty stereo if it ruins my tape. Addict for sneakers, 20s of Buddha and bitches with beepers. In the streets I could reach her, about blunts I teach her. Inhale deep like the words in my breath. I never sleep, cause sleep is the cousin of death. I lay puzzle as I backtrack to earlier times. Nothing's equivalent to the New York state of mind. State of mind. That's a great closing line there. I lay puzzles as I backtrack to earlier times. Nothing's equivalent to the New York state of mind. So there's nothing like that. Which I have to assume given the nature of what he's been discussing through these two very long verses. That New York is just fucking crazy. Living there is crazy. That kind of hustle is crazy. 152 million listens. Huh. That's a pretty good track. I mean, I know that wasn't the first one, but that's a good opening track since Genesis was kind of just an intro. That was good. I liked it. Good steady beat. Let's hear the next one. Track three is Life's a Bitch.
Yo, what's up? Let's keep it real, son. Count this money, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, yo, put the grants over there in the safe, you know what I'm saying? Because we spending these Jacksons. The Washingtons go to wifey. You know
Washingtons
that
go to wifey.
That's what this is all about, right? Clothes, bank, clothes, oh, you know what I'm saying? Yo, then what, man? What?
Visualizing the realism of life in actuality. Fuck who's the baddest. A person's status depends on salary. And my mentality is money orientated. I'm destined to live the dream for all my peeps who never made it. Cause yeah, we were beginners in the hood as proper sinners. But something must have got in us, cause all of us turned to sinners. Now some resting in peace and some are sitting in San Quentin. Others such as myself are trying to carry on tradition. Keeping this weapon wrestling street ghetto essence inside us. Cause it provides us with the proper insights that got us. Even though we know somehow we all gotta go. But as long as we leave and thieving, we'll be leaving with some kind of dough. So into that day we expire and turn to vapors. Me and my capers, I'll be somewhere stacking plenty papers. Keeping it real, packing still, getting high. Cause life's a bitch and then you die. Life's a bitch.
This opening verse is somewhat paradoxical to me because he's talking about, I'm destined to live the dream for all my peeps who never made it. You know, the people have died, the people have gone to prison. Others such as myself are trying to carry on tradition, the hustle, which that's the impression I got, because it provides us with the proper insight to guide us, even though we know somehow we all gotta go. But as long as we leave in thieving, we'll be leaving with some kind of dough. So here he implies that he's gonna stop that way of life at some point. Double entendre, leaving with some kind of dough, could be the pharaohs. A literal declaration that if they're leaving the area, they will have come up on something first, and that doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. Anyway, this is an interesting verse just because it seems a little bit contradictory. It seems to imply like he wants to stop doing this, but he needs money to get out. Like I need money to get out of the cycle, but the only way to get the money is to remain in the cycle. So maybe he's just discussing the idea of the contradiction that people are stuck in when they're in that way of life of I'm just trying to make it. And maybe they excuse it or justify it by saying, oh, I'm doing it so I can get out of this. But they never get out of it because that's their source of income. You know, kind of a catch-22 type situation. One person left a comment saying, you know, don't worry too much about the annotations and genius because it's like fan fiction, which I agree with on occasions. There have been some things I've read, I go, no, I don't see it that way. But, you know, opinions and assholes are all over the place.
Still packing, still getting high, cause life's a bitch and then you die. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we puff fly, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go.
Again, just a good classic steady beat.
I woke up early on my bond.
It's striking me. I'm assuming the whole album is going to have this general tone. You know, we're not going to have anything like New Slaves or Black Skinhead or anything like that. I don't think that kind of stuff existed back then. Something that I'm already really picking up on, and I don't want to hammer it too early or without merit in terms of what the album is saying, but you know, this is 94 and this is what he's singing about. And I've heard stuff from 20 years later and they're singing about the same thing, which to me tells me, and I mean, it's no surprise or mystery, but these cycles are not being broken. It's continuing. The same problems that were happening 30 years ago are still happening today. And I'm not trying to blame hip hop. I'm not trying to blame anybody. It just fucking bums me out, really. It bums me out. Anyway, okay, we'll let that idea just float for a bit because it's been sitting in my head. Now you guys kind of know where I'm at. I'm not going to make any judgments or speeches on it yet, but it's in my mind that this was happening then and it's still happening now. So let's just continue the ride and we'll see where it takes us.
Get high, cause you never know where you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we puff lie. I woke up early on my born day. I'm 20, it's a blessing. The essence of adolescence leaves my body now freshened. My physical frame is celebrated cause I made it. One quarter through life, some godly like thing created. Got rhymes, 365 days annual plus some. Load up the mic and bust one. Cuss while I puss from my skull cause it's pain in my brain vein. Money maintained, no go against the grain. Simple and plain. When I was younger, this I used to do my thing hard. Robbing foreigners, take their wallets, they jewels and rip their green cards. Get to the project, flashing my quick cash and got my first piece of ass smoking blunts with hash. Now it's all about cash in abundance. Niggas I used to run with is richer, doing years in the hundreds. I switched my motto. Instead of saying fuck tomorrow, that buck that bought a bottle could have struck the lotto. Once I stood on the block, loose cracks, produced stacks. I cooked up and cut small pieces to get my loot back. Time is ill-matic, keep static like wool fabric. Pack a formatic to crack your whole cabbage.
Life's a bitch and then you die.
Good verse. I feel like there's a meaning in here. I just kind of went over my head a little bit. Again, there's almost like a contradiction. He's talking, you know, he seems like he's happy to be alive at 20, which makes sense because I've heard other albums talking about, oh, what was it? College Dropout, you know, that first track with Kanye and that super sarcastic song about so happy to be alive. We made it past 25, you know, because people are just getting killed all the time in this kind of environment. So again, so that same idea is existing here, and he's celebrating the fact that he's still alive, and he's seeing life through a slightly changed lens. You know, he's not robbing people anymore. Now he's seeing, what's this other thing? That buck that bought a bottle could have struck the lotto. So he's seen. You know, instead of fuck tomorrow, he's seen, no, there's potential. I think I'm just going to translate it like that. Instead of fuck tomorrow, instead he'll see something where maybe there was minimal value. Now there's a lot of value. And maybe it's because his rapping career is taking off and he's not stuck in this little world of just petty crime and theft and, you know, trying to sell crack and steal shit to make money. All right. Let's keep going. This is interesting. On one hand, I want to listen to this and I hear the simplicity in relative terms, you know, compared to some of the music that's out now. This is, you know, more or less basic, but it's kind of the roots, the core of where all this comes from, which is cool. And even with the way he's doing his rhymes, same format, you know, he's not going fast or doing anything crazy like, you know, some of these other guys do, the more recent artists do. But in that simplicity, I feel myself kind of being tricked into this lull of kind of overlooking what Nas might say because, oh, it's just simple and it's basic, but it's not. I'm finding myself falling into the same bullshit misconception that I used to have about hip hop back then. You know, I never listened to this music back then. I thought it was all just stupid, you know, gang bullshit. And it's interesting now, 30 fucking years later, 25 years later, my brain is already trying to revert back to that mindset of dismissing this. And even though I can listen to it more now, there's still an element that exists of, oh, just don't even pay attention to what he's saying. And no, brain, we're here. We're here to analyze this and look at this and consider it. But it's interesting how it comes back to the surface.
To get my loot back, time is ill-matic. Keep static like wool fabric. Pack a formatic to crack your whole cabbage.
Life's a bitch and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch and then you die.
I haven't spoken about the music yet.
You never know when you're gonna go.
It's good, you know, good bass line in there. Just real simple beats. A good structure for him to rap over. Nice little trumpet there. And it is a little bit more of a somber tone, which pairs well with this concept of life is a bitch and then you die. It's almost sad. That trumpet adds to it. Yeah, okay. That was good. That was track three. Track four is The World Is Yours.
World is yours, the world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, whose world is this?
I sit the dumb peep watching Gandhi till I'm.
So I did that, I made that sound because it's been a while since I've heard a record. Which I imagine this was actually a record that did that sound. It's been a while since
I've been writing in my book of rhymes, all the words past the margin. The whole of mic I'm throbbing, mechanical movement, understandable smooth shit that murderers move with. The thief's theme, the play theme. Me at night, they won't act right. The fiend of hip hop has got me stuck like a crack pipe. The mind activation, react like I'm facing time like Pappy Mason. With pins I'm embracing, wipe the sweat off my dome, spit the phlegm on the streets. Suede Tim's on my feet, makes my cipher complete. Weather cruising in a six cab, I'm on tarot jeep, I can't call it. The beats make me falling asleep, I keep falling, but never falling 6 feet deep. I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for dead presidents to represent me.
Whose world is this?
The world is yours, the world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine.
I like the beat more on this one, a little bit more active. A little bit more going on. There's a couple of layers. It's I don't know if it's exactly piano, but it's got a piano sound to it. Could be maybe a keyboard to sound like a piano. The beat's a little bit faster. The tempo's a little bit faster. I'm liking this jam a little bit more so far, just in terms of pace.
It's to represent me.
Whose world is this?
The world is yours. The world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Whose world is this?
The world is yours.
What's cool too is that piano.
It's mine, it's mine.
It's kind of got some lo-fi sound, which is neat. I always like the lo-fi, some of the crackling and the popping that goes with it.
The world is yours, the world is yours. To my man Ill Will, God bless your life. To my peoples, the wild queens, God bless your life. I trick, we box some crazy bitches, aiming guns and all my baby pictures. Beef with housing police, release scriptures, that's maybe Hitler's. Yet I'm the mal, money getting stabbed, rolling foul. The versatile, honey, sticking wild, golden child, dwelling in the rotten apple. You get tackled, a caught by the devil's lasso. Shit is a hassle. There's no days for broke days, we selling smoke pays while all the old folks pray. The Jesus soaking they sins in trays. A holy water, odds against nods and slaughter. Finger the word best describing my life. To name my daughter my strength. My son the star will be my resurrection. Born in correction, all the wrong shit I did. He'll lead in right direction. How you living large or broke or charge cards are mediocre. You're flipping coca, playing spit spades and strip poker. Poker.
He's got some good verses, man. He's got some good verses. There's no days for broke days when selling smoke pays. When all the old folks pray to Jesus, soaking their sins in trays of holy water. Thinking a word best describing my life to name my daughter. My strength, my son, the star will be my resurrection. Born in Christ. Yeah, these are good verses, man. I can see why this is so highly regarded. I mean, what's cool is it's weird. Like, he's putting in a lot of work, and there's a lot that he's saying, but it isn't awkward. It's very comfortable. It's very smooth, you know? What's an analogy? It's like watching somebody who's just, you know, whatever job that they do, it requires a lot of hand-eye coordination and just fast movement. And for the casual onlooker, it looks like they're doing something that's crazy. But when you watch them, they're just very comfortable, just doing their thing. Like a blackjack dealer. You know, some of these people, they can just deal. And it's like, holy shit, you're coming out fast. I can barely keep up. And this person's just like, no, I can do this all day. That's how I feel about this. It's not that he's going super fast. You know, he's not using a bunch of crazy words. It's all pretty straightforward, but he does it really well, and it's got a great structure, and it flows really well. That's what I'm noticing. All right, let's wrap this one. Oh, we still got a couple minutes.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Whose world is this?
yours, the world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, whose world is this? It's mine, it's mine, it's mine, whose world is this?
Yo, the world is yours, the world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, it's mine, whose world is this?
It's so nice to hear record scratching again. It's been forever. That's so cool, man. You know, and one thing I'm smiling so much because that was something I never used to appreciate. I mean, I always kind of heard it. Back then, like, yeah, okay, you know, whatever, they're doing their thing. But I have a lot more appreciation for it now. So much so, we're going to back it up, and we're going to listen to that little bit again. It's cool. Oh, man.
Single-handed for murder raps, I kick my thoughts alone, get remanded, born alone, die alone, no crew to keep my crown a throne, I'm deep, I sound alone, cave inside a 1,000 miles from home, I need a new nigga for this black cloud to follow, cause while it's over me, it's too dark to see tomorrow, trying to maintain, I flip, feel the clip to the tip, picturing my peeps, now the ink can make my heartbeat skip, and I'm amped up, they like to champ up, even my brain's in handcuffs, headed for Indiana, stabbing women like the Phantom, the crew is laughing, Big Willie style, check the chip to smell, plus I post bow wow, stash through the flock, clothes burning dollars, delight my stove, walk the blocks with a bop. Checking dames plus the games people play, bust the problems of the world today.
I really, really like the line of even my brain's in handcuffs. I really like that line a lot. That's a great way to describe just. I guess he's really trying to describe anxiety, but really I just think of whatever's happening. He's so restricted in what's going on around him that even his brain, like he just can't even fucking think straight. He can't think freely because of all this shit that's going on, man. That's really a really good line. Okay, let's keep going. This is going to take forever. This album is only 40 minutes, it'll probably be like a 2-hour video.
The world is yours, the world is yours.
It's mine, it's mine, whose world is this?
Yeah, I tell everybody in Queens, the foundation. The world is yours to everybody uptown. Yo, the world is yours. The world is yours to everybody in Brooklyn. Y'all know the world is yours. The world is yours. Everybody in Mount Vernon. The world is yours. Long Island. Yo, the world is yours. Staten Island. Yeah, the world is yours. South Bronx. The world is yours.
That was a cool jam. I really liked that jam. I think, you know, New York State of Mind was really good. Based off of the listens, that's the most popular from this album. But I like the beat in that one a little bit more. The World is Yours. I like that song quite a bit. And actually, it's got almost 93 million views. So I think that's the second most popular off of the album. That's a great jam. That's a great jam. All right, track 5 is Halftime. God, again, it's just got that great ride, old school beat.
Check me out, y'all. Ride. Nasty Nas in your area. About to cause mass hysteria.
Before a blunt, I take out my fronts, then I start the front. Matter of fact, I'll be on a manhunt. You couldn't catch me in the streets without a ton of reefer. That's like Malcolm X catching a jungle fever. King poetic, too much flavor, I'm major. Atlanta ain't braver, I pull a number like a pager. Cause I'm an ace when I face the base. 40 side is the place that is giving me grace. Now wait, another dose, say you might be dead. And I'm a Nike head, I wear chains that excite the feds. It ain't a damn thing gonna change. I'm a performer, strange show, the mic warmer was born the game. Nas, why did you do it? You know you got the mad fat fluid when you rhyme. It's halftime.
Cool little change up there.
It's halftime.
I like the use of lo-fi. It's pretty cool. It really does give it that old school feel too. I really like this line about I wear chains that excite the feds. That's a good one because I feel like it means it's so fancy that he can only, you know, it costs a shit ton of money, which means he has to be doing a little illegal activity to be able to get something like that. Oh, good. My smoke fucking alarm is chirping. That's good. That's very convenient. Great line. Great line. Good. Again, good lines all throughout. Good, strong verses. His voice is nice, too. You know, it's just solid, easy to listen to.
Like that. You know it's like that. I got it him, now you never get the mic back. When I attack, there ain't an army that can strike back. So I react never calmly on a hype track. I set it off with my own rhyme. Cause I'm as ill as a convict who kills for phone time. I'm max like a sex, a flex like sex. And your stereo sets, Nas a catch wreck. I used to hustle, now all I do is relax and strive. When I was young, I was a fan of the Jackson 5. I drop jewels, wear jewels, hope to never run it. With more kicks than a baby in a mother's stomach. Nasty Nas has to rise, cause I'm wise. This is exercise till the microphone dies. Back in 83, I was an MC sparking. But I was too scared to grab the mics in the parks and kick my little raps. Cause I thought niggas wouldn't understand. And now in every jam, I'm a fucking man.
This is a really neat verse or section right here through the verse. Back in 83, I was an MC sparking, but too scared to grab the mics. This is cool. I mean, it's fun to go back to 94, where this album is, and then to think where he is at that time period and what he went back to, where he came from. And that's really some of the rabbit hole I want to get down into, is I know what, you know, the earliest things groups I can think of are like Run DMC, what was it, A Tribe Called Quest. I never really listened to any of those guys. But I know that's kind of like the early beginnings of hip hop, at least from what I understand. I mean, I could be wrong. I probably am wrong. But it's interesting. It's just neat to see where all this stuff comes from, where it springs from, and then who gets inspired going forward and how their music changes and grows and how that affects the whole genre. And it's just fucking awesome seeing those ripple effects go through. Let's go back. I really hope my smoke detector does not keep chirping. I'm going to have to pause it and fix that.
Back in 83, I was an MC sparking, but I was too scared to grab the mics in the parks and kick my little raps because I thought niggas wouldn't understand. And now in every jam, I'm a fucking man. I rap in front of more niggas than in the slave ship. I used to watch chips, now I load plot clips. I got to have it. I miss Mr. Magic. Versatile. My style switches like a faggot, but not bisexual. I'm an intellectual rap. I'm a professional. That's no question, yo.
These oh, God.
Other, man. You can't never understand, cause in the streets I'm well known like the number man. In my place with the bass and format, explore rap. And tell me Nas ain't all that. And next time I rhyme, I'll be foul. Whenever I freestyle, I see trial. Niggas say I'm wow. I hate a rhyme, fight his rhyme. Stay tuned, I assume the real rap comes at halftime.
That's fucking good, man. Another solid verse. And it's interesting that they call this a verse because really it's more of a bridge than a chorus. I mean, it's barely a chorus, it's more of a bridge.
I got it going on, even flip a morning song. Every afternoon I kick half the tune. And in the darkness I'm heartless like when the narcs hit word. The mark is garbage, a heartless
sparked it. Cause when I blast the herb, that's my word. I be slaying them fast, doing this, that, and the third. But chill, Pastor Andre, and let's lay. I bag bitches up at John Jay and hit a matinee. Putting hits on 5-0. Cause when it's my time to go, I wait for God with the fofo. And
oh, shit, can't come man. Near.
And you'll go to hell to the fell cop who shot Garcia. I won't plant seeds, don't need an extra mouth I can't feed. That's extra Philly change, more cash for damp weed. This goes out to Manhattan, the Allen of Staten. Brooklyn and Queens is living fat in the boogie down. Enough props, enough clout. Yeah, we'll rest in peace, yo, I'm out.
That was fucking great, man. Which one's this one? Halftime. This is another good jam.
It's still halftime.
That was a good jam. Good jam. One thing I'm doing too is I'm paying attention to the sound because clearly he's from New York. And I know there's this whole East Coast, West Coast rap thing. And I know that was a somewhat of a big deal in the 90s. There was like these, I don't want to say conflict, but I mean, there was beef between the two sides. But I'm really trying to pick up on what East Coast sounds like. So when I listen to something that's West Coast, like Tupac next week, I'll have something to compare it to, you know? That's a cool jam. Actually, I'm going to pause. You're going to be seeing a little bit of a break right here. I got to go fix my fucking smoke detector. Yay. All right. Let us resume. Moving on to track 6, which is Memory Lane.
I fuck that shit. Word. Fuck that other shit, you know what I'm saying? We gon' do a little something like this, you know what I'm saying?
Stay up on this.
Keep it on and on and on and on and, you know what I'm saying? Big Nas, Grand Wizard, dog, what is it
like?
You know what I'm saying?
Yo, gang.
I rap for listeners, blunt heads, fly ladies and prisoners, Hennessy holders and old school
again,
niggas,
great
then
beat,
I'll be kissing
yeah.
The unofficials that mo' woolly tie. I dropped out of coolie high, gas the bar, cocaine, cutie pie, jungle survivor, fuck who's the lava. My man put the battery in my back, a difference from energizer, sentence begins to dent it. With formality, moderation's infinite, money-wise a physiology, poetry that's a part of me. Retardedly bop, I dropped the ancient manifested hip-hop, straight off the block, I reminisce a park chance, my man was shot for a sheep coat. Chaco blessing, make me see I'm dropping my weed smoke. It's real, grew up in tripe life, the times of white lines, the high fives, murderous night times, the night fights and bright crimes.
I hate pausing in the, well, I guess the verse was almost done. I want to go back just right here. My man was shot for his sheep coat. Mink coat. Dangerous to wear one. You got killed for him. His friend was shot for his sheep coat. Interesting. That was another thing that I still struggle with when it comes to hip hop, you know, kind of on the cultural level, is there's this desire to always wear flashy things and prove that you get all this money. And then you're doing it in an environment where many people are carrying weapons of some kind, usually guns. And it's like when you're in an environment where, you know, there's kind of a pride thing of taking somebody else's shit or at least robbing them, why would you want to walk around with all this fly shit? Like, I guess, I don't know. Is it like a way of taunting? Like saying, I made it, I got it, you ain't got it. I don't know. It was always very confusing to me. It's still confusing to me. Like, I'm very much the opposite of, if I have nice things, I try and hide it because I don't want anybody stealing my shit. You know, that's just me. If you guys can explain that a little bit to me in the comments, please feel free. Please understand that I'm coming from a place of complete ignorance. So, you know, don't light me up too much on it. But I've always been confused by that. I'm going to wear expensive shit in a neighborhood where people rob each other all the time. Oh, my God. All right, let's back it up just a little bit and we'll get back in.
We smoke, it's real, grew up in tripe life, the times of white lines, the high fives, murderous night times, the night fights and bright crimes. Chill on the block with Carniaco strap, with my peeps that's in the drug money market interact. No sign of the beast and a blue Chrysler, I guess that means peace for niggas, no shice device to just snipe ya. Start up the dice, roll the match for crap to CeeLo, with side bets, so roll the deuce, nothing below.
Peace, God.
Peace, God, now the shit is explained, I'm taking niggas on a trip straight through memory lane. It's like that, y'all. It's like that, y'all. It's like that, y'all.
record. I like the beat in this one too. It's super chill. It is interesting to me that I'm getting the impression from the music strictly. I mean, the lyrics too, but for the most part, the music, that this is a chill song. No, well, actually, the lyrics don't really give me that impression. But the music, I mean, this is just chill. And I'm thinking back, I remember being a kid in this time and when rap was really exploding big time, especially the gangster rap and all that stuff, and people were so upset about the sound and blah, 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 and it was so aggressive and aggressive and abrasive and aggressive. How about these words? I'll try these words instead. Abrasive and aggressive. Those are actually words. And it's so weird to listen to the music now and just be like, yeah, this is cool. This is chill. I'm just nodding my head to it. I'm just rolling to it. And I think back to the bullshit I was told about hip hop and rap and gangsters and fucking, you know, and their low riders and all this shit, you know, and how, you know, they're bumping this music and blah, 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 and they're just looking out for trouble. But really, these guys were just fucking chilling. They were just chilling. So many people were driving around listening to this music, chilling, just hanging out, just like I'm hanging out right now. Only they're doing it with their buddies in the car. It's kind of a mind fuck, man. It really is. Like, the amount of misconception that I had back then and until like a year ago, 6 months ago, is pretty incredible. I'm gonna have to like go outside and meditate for a while and really think about this, because it's wild. Like, I'm listening to this, I'm just like, yeah, this is a cool jam. But 30 years ago or 25 years ago or 10 years ago, if I would have heard somebody listening to this song, not knowing what it was, and they're driving their car, I'm, oh shit, here comes trouble. What the fuck? What the fuck am I even thinking? What am I even talking about? You know? This is a chill jam. Like, I would feel totally cool just rolling my car, bumping this. Okay. Sorry, this is, I know, a little long-winded, but I'm like processing my own personal shit right now. I love hearing the record scratch. I really do love it. Especially now that I can appreciate it.
One for the money, two for a pussy and foreign calls, three for Alizé, niggas deceased the behind bars. I rap the vanguard, check that prognosis, is it real or showbiz? My window faces, shootouts, drug overdoses, live amongst the roses, only the drama. For real, a nickel plate is my fate, my medicine is the ganja. Here's my basis, my razor embraces many faces. Your telephone blown, black stitches or bad shoelaces. People's a petrol, dramatic, automatic, fofo. I let blow and back down, popo when I'm vexed. So my pen taps the paper, then my brain's blank. I see dark streets. Hustling brothers who keep the same rank, pumping for something. Some are prosperous or fail. Judges hanging niggas, uncorrect bails. For direct sales, my intellect prevails. For my hanging cross with nails, I reinforce my frail. With lyrics that's real. Word to Christ, a disciple of streets. Trifle on beats, I decipher prophecies. Through a mic that say peace. I hung around the older rules while they sling smack the ding bass. They spoke with fat cat, that nigga's name ain't bell rings. Blacks a face scream about Supreme Team of Jamaica Queens thing. Uptown was outpost, son. Heard he was kingpin, yo. Fuck rappers. Watch the herbs stand still. Never talking to snakes, cause the words a man kill. True in the game, as long as blood is blue in my vein. I pull my Heineken brew to my deceased crew in memory lane.
The front half of this verse is fucking awesome. Check the prognosis. Is it real or showbiz? My window faces shootouts, drug overdoses, live amongst no roses, only the drama. For real, nickel plate is my fate. Which I imagine has to be like the pistol. My medicine is the ganja. Here's my basis. My razor embraces many faces. So I've got to assume, I've got to assume this line. Your telephone blown, black stitches or fat shoelaces. I don't know what that means, but that line, my razor embraces many faces. I have to assume that he's saying when he looks in the mirror, when he's shaving, he sees so many other people who are stuck in the same situation that he's in. That's what I assume. That's what I assume. I'm going to click this to see if that's even close to being accurate. A telephone cut or blow is a cut on your face that extends from your ear to your mouth. Huh. I don't know what the fuck that means. Looks like I was incredibly wrong. But I like the idea. I like the idea. And I also like the idea, or the fact that he used the word vexed, because I love the word vexed. My pen taps the paper, then my brain's blank. I see dark streets, hustling brothers who keep the same rank. Dark streets, people keeping the same rank. Pumping for something, some will prosper, some will fail. That's really, I like that too. This idea of seeing dark streets and seeing people who are basically stuck there. And they're trying and they're trying, and some make it and some don't, but for the most part, they're stuck there. Judges hanging people, incorrect bails for direct sales. My intellect prevails from a hanging cross with nails. So I'm assuming that line means he's pulling his source of knowledge, where his strength, his intellectual strength from God, from religion. That was a great verse. I really liked that verse. Okay, there's about a minute left. We're gonna crank this out. Ah, that record scratch, man. It's so great. It's been so long, so great. And I like the kind of the supporting vocals that are sitting in the background. Man. Cool jam. I like that one too. Memory Lane. The World Is Yours, Halftime, Memory Lane, all great tracks. I mean, really, this, I can see why people regard this album so highly, because so far every track's been really fucking good. All right, track 7 is One Love.
Word is born, you got 6 minutes on that jack kid, shit is real.
Hey, yo, check this shit out, man.
Hey, yo, go, give me a cigarette, man.
Yo, here you go, here you go, here you go. Check it out, man. Check out what I got here, man.
What is that?
Yo, it's a letter I got from my man Nas, man. Word is born.
What it say, kid?
What up, kid? I know shit is rough doing your bit. When the cops came, you should have slid to my crib. Fuck it, black, no time for looking back is done. Plus, congratulations, you know you got a son. I heard he looks like you. Why don't your lady write you? Told her she should visit, that's when she got hyper. Flipping, talking about he acts too rough. He didn't listen, he be ripping while I'm telling him stuff. I was like, yeah, shorty don't care. She a snake too. Fucking with them niggas from that fake crew that hate you. But yo, guess who got shot in the dome piece? Jerome. Niece on her way home from Jones Beach's bug. Plus little Rob is selling drugs on a dime, hanging out with young thugs that all carry nines. And nighttime is more tripe than ever. What up with Port Mega? Did you see him or y'all together? If sold and hold a foot down.
I like the I don't know how to describe that sound, but it's a lighter tinkling sound in the background. It's a pretty cool sound. This fucking line, man. Guess who got shot in the dome piece? Jerome's niece on her way home from Jones Beach. When it gets to the kids, man, I mean, it's already a shit sandwich when so much of this exists to begin with, but then when fucking kids just start getting killed because they existed in the wrong place at the wrong time for no reason whatsoever, you know, they're just getting killed. I fucking hate that shit. All right, I want to get on the soapbox, but I'm going to let the soapbox go by a little bit.
Been selling drugs on a dime, hanging out with young thugs that all carry nines. And nighttime is more tripe than ever. What up with Port Mega? Did you see him or y'all together? If sold and hold a foot down, represent to the fullest. Say what's up to Herb, Ice, and Bullet. I left for half a hundred in your commissary. You was my nigga when push came to shove.
One what?
One love.
One love. One love. One love. One love. One love.
I do appreciate how minimal sound is coming through to make this song. Just a couple beats, a couple sounds, and that's it.
You'll be out soon,
gon' stay strong. Out in New York, the same shit is going on. The crackhead stalking, loud mouths is talking. Ho, check out the story yesterday when I was walking. That nigga get shot last year, try to appear like he hurt something. Word him up, I heard him frontin', and he be pumping on your block. Your man gave him your Glock, and now they run together. What up, son? Whatever. Since I'm on the streets, I'ma put it to a cease. But I heard you blew a nigga with an ox for the phone piece. Wildin' on the Allen, but now with Elmira, better chill, cause them niggas will put that ass on fire. Last time you wrote, you said they tried you in the showers. But maintain when you come home, the corner's ours on the rails. All these crap niggas know the deal. When we start the revolution, all they probably do is squeal. But chill, see you on the next VI. I gave you my Duke's loop for kicks, plus sent your flicks. Your brother's Buck Wildin' in Fort Maine. He wrote me, he might be this case silly. Come home, I'm playing low key. So stay civilized, time flies. No incarcerated, your mind dies. I hate it when your mom's cries. It kinda makes me wanna murder, for realer. I even got a mask and gloves to bust slugs, but one love.
One love, one love, one love.
So I wanna see who did this first. Nas did that one. Oh, Nas has done both of these. Oh, Q-Tip is doing the one love part, okay. So it sounds like these are letters being written back and forth. It sounds like on this verse, he's writing back to someone who is in prison and letting them know what's going on. The first verse, I don't know who that is written to. This is a neat jam though. Again, great. I mean, I'm just saying this over and over again. Great lyrics, great rhythm, very comfortable. That's what I'm enjoying the most from Nas and his lyrics so far and his vocals. He seems very comfortable. There's no struggle. There's no strain. He's not trying to make too much happen. He's just doing his thing, man. That's a great, great flow going through here. Let's keep going.
A Buddha sack, minds in another world, thinking how can we exist through the facts written in school textbooks, Bibles, etc. Fuck a school lecture, the lies get me vexed up. So I be ghosts for my projects. I take my pen and pad for the weekend, hitting nails while I'm sleeping. A 2-day stay, you may say I needed time alone to relax my dome. No phone left and not at home. You see, the streets had me stressed, something terrible. Fucking with the pointers, have a nigga up in Bellevue at HDM, hit with numbers from 8 to 10. A future in a maximum state pen, it's grim. So I comes back home, nobody's out with Shorty Doo-Wop. Rolling two Phillies together in the prison, we call them OOPs. He said, Nas, niggas call me busting off the roof. So I wear a bulletproof, a pack of black Trey Deuce. He inhaled so deep, shut his eyes like he was sleep. Started coughing when I peeked to watch me speak. I sat back like the Mac, my army suit was black. We was chilling on these benches where he pumped his loose cracks. I took the L when he passed it. This little bastard keeps me blasted and starts talking mad shit. I had to school him, told him, don't let niggas fool him. Cause when the pistol blows, the one that's murder be the cool one. Tough luck when niggas are struck, families fucked up. Could have caught your man but didn't look when you bucked up. Mistakes happen, so take heed. Never bust up at the crowd, catch him solo, make the right man bleed. Shorty's laugh was cold-blooded as he spoke so foul. Only 12 trying to tell me that he liked my style. Then I rose, wiping the blunt's ass from my clothes and froze, only to blow the earth smoke through my nose and told my little man I'm a ghost. I bros left some jewels in his skull that he could sell if he chose. Words of wisdom from Nas, try to rise up above, keep an eye out for Dick. Shorty, walk one love.
That's cool. I like that closing section there from that verse. That was really cool.
To all my niggas locked up for Queens Bridge and all over. To my man Gorman. One love. To my man Her. One love.
So that was a cool jam. With this last verse, with this section about where he's talking to this 12-year-old kid and telling him to rise up, So one of the reasons why I wanted to listen to this album now, and I want to do Tupac next, is because after Tupac, I'm going to do To Pimp a Butterfly. And so I wonder right here on this section of the verse, if this is something that Kendrick listened to, you know? I have no idea. I have no idea. It's entirely possible. I'm sure if, you know, if Kendrick, if this came out in 94, I don't know where Kendrick was in his life and what he was dealing with or what his age was or anything like that. Good Kid, Mad City was 2012, I believe. I think. I'm not going to look it up. But it's entirely possible, probable, in my opinion, that Kendrick has probably listened to this song. And I just, it's crazy how, you know, we all go through life and we all have our experiences, our ups and downs, all these different things. And those of us who love music and have music so interwoven with our own experiences, it's amazing how certain songs and certain lines from either songs that are popular or from songs that nobody even knows will just stick, you know, they'll stick. And I wonder if these lines stuck with Kendrick. I wonder if he heard these and just said, yeah, I'm going to rise up. Especially considering on Memory Lane, that he's referring back to, you know, there's a couple lines there about how he gets his intellectualism from God, and, you know, that's what's helping him write these verses and stuff like that. Because Kendrick also has that in as an element in his life when he's, you know, singing about what he's doing, what he's dealing with. Cool. Cool jam. Okay. Track 8 is One Time for Your Mind.
Yeah. It's Illmatic.
Yeah.
It's Illmatic.
Yeah.
It's Illmatic.
One time for your mind, one time.
Yeah, whatever.
One time for your mind, one time.
Yo, whatever.
One time for your mind, one time. Hey, yo, nah.
What up,
pick that fucking rhyme. Check it out. When I'm chilling,
I grab.
I don't know why. But I really like the way he said that. Yeah, what up? That fucking rhyme.
One time for your mind, one time.
Yo, whatever.
One time for your mind, one time. Hey, yo, nah.
What up, Paul?
That fucking rhyme.
Check it out. When I'm chilling, I grab the boot and get my crew to buy beers and watch a flick, illin and root for the villain, huh? Plus every morning I go out and love it sort of chilly. Then I send a shorty from my block to the store for Phillies. After being blessed by the herb's essence,
what?
I'm back to my rest 10 minutes, some odd seconds.
Yeah.
That's where I got the honey at. Spends the night for sexin'. Keep lubrication, lifestyle protection. Picking up my stereos, remote control quickly. Ron G's in the cassette deck, rocking the shit, G. I try to stay mellow rock. Well, acapella rhymes that make me richer than a slipper made Cinderella fella. Go get your crew, Hobbs, I'm prepared to bomb troops. Y'all niggas was born, I shot my way out, my mom dukes. When I was 10, I was a hip hopping shorty wop. Known for rocking microphones and twisting off a 40 top. Yeah.
One time for.
Couple of things are striking me with this track. First, I really want to go back and do Cypress Hill Black Sunday. I'm going to do that. I don't know when. I want to do it right now. Like, I want to finish recording this and jump right into Black Sunday, but I can't. Another thing, I was just, I don't know, there's something about the sound on this opening verse here. I want to say it reminds me of Rage Against the Machine. And I don't know if it's just the way the lyrics are coming through or if it's the bass line. Something. Rage, I believe Rage also came out in 94, that first album. I don't know, there's just something there. I can't quite put my finger on it. Something, some parallel that exists there. Anyway, I like this guy's style. I really do. This is a great... I mean, he's basically just telling little stories about his days, you know, different things that are going on. But it's got great rhythm. I mean, he just goes with the beat and just goes and goes and goes. I like that his verses are nice and long, and he really lets his story unfold. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Let's keep bumping.
When I was 10, I was a hip hop
the shorty wop. Known for rocking microphones and twisting off a 40 top. Yeah.
One time for your mind, one time.
Yeah, whatever.
One time for your mind, one time.
It sound clever.
Hey, yo, nah, fuck that, man. That shit was fat. But kick that for them gangsters, man. Fuck all that, man.
Right, right. What up, niggas? How y'all? It's Nasty, the villain. I'm still writing rhymes, but besides that, I'm chilling. I'm trying to get this money, God. You know the hard times, kid. Shit, Kobe starving, make you want to do crimes, kid. But I'm a lamp, because a crime couldn't be the rhyme. Niggas catch a 3 to 9s, Muslims yelling freedom mine. And I'm from Queensbridge, been to many places. As a kid, when I would say that out of town, niggas chased us. But now I know the time, got an older mind, plus control of 9. Fine, see now I represent mine. I'm new on the rap scene, brothers never heard of me. Yet I'm a menace, yo, police wanna murder me. Nighty dog blinker, represent the thinker. My pen rides the paper, it even has blinkers. Think I'll dim the lights, then inhale. It stimulates, floating like I'm on the North 95 interstate. Never plan to stop when I write, my hand is hot. And expand a lot from the Wiz to Camelot. The parlayer, I make your heads bop, paw. I shine a light on perpetrators like a cop's car. From day to night, I play the mic and you'll thank God. I wreck shit so much the microphone and need a big job. My brain is incarcerated. Live at any jam, I couldn't count all the blocks I raided. A hole of Mac 11 and attack a reverend. I'll contact 11 L's and Max in heaven.
Oh my God, man. I was just thinking on that last verse, you know, I really let it just play for a while and I was listening to it and I was enjoying it. And I said it earlier how it's easy to listen to. And I don't know if it's just the way that the genre itself has evolved so much from what existed back in the 90s. I don't know if it's just society itself has evolved so much and changed over the last 30 years. I don't know what it is. But it's really easy to listen to this. And again, I was just thinking about how this used to throw me off so much, you know? And I can't, for the life of me right now, figure out why. Why the fuck would a simple beat and just, you know, a simple beat and a couple of sounds and somebody rapping, why the fuck would that ever be unsettling ever? And it just comes from the fact that I had no idea what it was about. And I fucking just basically lied to from the fucking news. I hate the mainstream media so much. I hate them so much. They're just fucking garbage, man. This Kyle Rittenhouse thing is really... It's been nice, in a sense, that so many people have been surprised by the information that came out in the trial. Because the media never fucking said it. They just, it's the lie of omission, people. The lie of omission. Here's an example of the lie of omission. You go, you know, you're at home. You tell your girl, hey, I'm gonna go get some food. I'll be right back. All right. Come back about a half hour later. She goes, what took so long? You tell her, well, I don't know. I mean, the drive-through lane was kind of slow. There's a lot of cars. And I don't know, service was just kind of slow. Now, is it true that there were a lot of cars in the drive-through lane? Yeah. That's true. Not a lie. Is it true that the service was kind of slow? Yep. It's true. Not a lie. So you told two truths there. What you omitted, what you lied about by not mentioning was you also got a blowjob from a crackhead for $20 or $10. I don't know what the going rate is. I have no idea. The lie of omission. We're just going to continually not tell you certain bits of information so that we can make the story appear a certain way. And every fucking mainstream media outlet does that. And I am upset about that for all the obvious reasons, but I'm personally upset by it now because I'm listening to this now, remembering what I used to think about it then and how my perspective is completely different from All I did was listen to what? All I've done is listen to 15 albums. I don't even think I've listened to 15 albums. I think I've done 10. Maybe I've done 15 albums. I've barely scratched the surface of hip hop. And I have a completely different perspective on it. Oh, well. You know, at least I figured it out at some point in time. Even though it's upsetting. Some old dogs can learn new tricks, you guys. Some old dogs can learn new tricks. All right, let's wrap this up.
One time, one time for your mom, one time. Yeah, whatever. One time for
I mean, this
mom,
is so cool.
Yo, from 92
who the fuck doesn't want to get in their car and just roll to this?
Yeah,
you know, especially if you're smoking pot. Dude, roll the window down. I mean, who doesn't want to just drive around and bump to that? All right. Moving on, moving on. Track 9 is called Represent. And what a perfect fucking segue into a song where it's a bunch of people singing together, having fun. A bunch of friends hanging out with their music, having fun.
Shit is real and any day could be your last in the jungle. Get murdered on the humble, guns of blast, niggas tumble. The corners is the hot spot full of mad criminals who don't care. Guzzling beers, we all stare at the out of towners. They better break north before we get the 4 pounders and take their face off. The streets is filled with undercovers, homicide chasing brothers. The D's on the roof trying to watch us and knock us and kill a coppers, even come through in helicopters. I drink a little vodka, spark a L and hold a Glock for the fronters. Wanna be ill niggas and spot runners, thinking it can't happen till I trap them and clap them and leave them done. Won't even run about guards, I don't believe in none of that shit. Your facts are backwards. Nas is a rebel of the street corner, pulling the tech out the dresser. Police got me under pressure.
You know, and God, I apologize that this album is just turning into my own personal bullshit. I hope that you guys can appreciate that I am going through like some internal conflict on this, that I am really kind of opening up some hidden bullshit that's existed in my mind for a long time. Why was I saying this? You know, if you are an outsider to hip hop and you listen to this verse, all you hear is, oh my God, gun violence, and they're running from the cops, and they're doing all this. It's just bad people, bad people, bad people. And on the surface, that's what it looks like. But if you actually take the fucking time to listen, he's talking about the environment that he lives in. And okay, maybe you can make the case that he's trying to glamorize it. I've never really gotten the impression from the albums I've heard so far that the people who sing this music are trying to glamorize it, maybe romanticize it a little bit, maybe, but this idea of we're going to promote it to make it sound like a positive thing, we're going to glamorize it, no, fuck no. Now, you can make the case of the guys that were, you know, early and they were down and they didn't have any money and they were looking up to the rappers who had money, but it wasn't about anything involving, you know, violence. I mean, the violence and the drugs and the money and the women, it's all part of this environment that kind of coexists, unfortunately. And it wasn't what they wanted to be rappers so that they could keep existing in a world of violence. It's because they wanted to get the fuck out. They wanted to get out. Those are the impressions I've gotten. You guys will straighten me out if I'm wrong. Hopefully I'm not wrong. I would really be upset to find out I've misinterpreted a lot of stuff, but I've never gotten this idea, this bullshit idea of they're glamorizing violence. They're glamorizing this horrible lifestyle. No, they're singing about the fucking environment that they're in, you know? The D's, I assume that's the DEA, on the roof trying to watch us and knock us, so I assume that's a no-knock raid because they're trying to bust them for running drugs. But why are they running drugs? Because they ain't got fucking anything else. They can't make money anyway else. They got nothing on them. What was the other song? I can't remember now. It was a guest, and it was something about, you know, what are you going to do when you're living off government cheese? He's talking about just fucking, yeah, you got to run drugs. You got to do something to try and make it somehow, to make some fucking money, try and take care of your family. Man, super preachy on this one. Sorry, I apologize. Let's keep going. God damn. Oh, man. This is good for me. This is a bit of a turmoil, but this is good for me. I'm learning some shit about myself, and that's a good thing. And then there's this, where these guys are just fucking trying to enjoy themselves with their friends, you know?
slogan street dweller who's always on the corner rolling up blessed when I dress is never nothing less than guests. Kobe walking with a pop in my hat turned back, love committing sins in my friend's cell crack, this nigga raps with a razor.
And I say all that shit, and this guy comes back saying, love committing sins with my friends. What? My friends sell crack. Anyway. Great beat. I mean, it's just, it's so easy to listen to.
See my stats are fat, this is what it's about. Before the BDP conflict with MC Shan, around the time with Shantae, just the real Roxanne. I used to wake up every morning, see my crew on the block. Every day's a different planet, had us running for cops. If it wasn't hanging out in front of cocaine spots, we was at the candy factory, breaking the locks. Nowadays, I need the green and the flash, just like the next man. Fuck a yard guard, let me see $100,000. Could use a gun some, but fuck being a wanted man. But if I hit rock bottom, then I'ma be the son of Sam. They call the crew to get live too, with Sue Walk here, my brother Jungle Big Bo cooks up the blow, Micah chop it, Mayo you count the profit. My shit is on the streets, this way to Jake should never stop it. Is your brain on drugs, to all fly bitches and thugs. Enough respect to the project, some ghost one love. Represent y'all, represent.
Enough respect to the projects. I'm ghost. One love. Does that mean he's gone? Oh, leave the studio. Okay. I feel like that's not what he means. Leave the studio. My shit on the streets. It's your brain on drugs. Enough respect to the projects. I'm ghost. I feel like he's saying I'm leaving. I'm leaving the projects. I love you. I respect you. I'll represent you, but I'm leaving, as you should. Everybody should want to leave that situation. That's always the impression I've gotten, trying to get out of this shit. They're just stuck in it. Huh. I don't agree with this annotation. Bold. I know. That's bold. Oh, my God. He's disagreeing with the annotation. All right. Let's keep going. Oh, my God.
Living a real fucking life in every projects all over. To my man Big Will, we still here. The 40 side of burning. My man Big LES, Big CeeLo from the Dime, Sean Penn, the 40 Busters. My crew the Shorty Busters, the 41st side of burning posse, the Goodfellas. My man Cormega, Lakey the Kid, can't forget Drawers, the Hillbillies. My man Slate, Wallet Head, Black J, Big Spot.
Big Dog.
We rock shit a lot. Malachi, PhD, and my man Primo from Gangstar.
94 real shit, Charles. Real shit, Charles. Harry, yo.
Fuck y'all crab ass niggas, though.
Bitch ass niggas. Bitch ass niggas.
Bitch ass motherfucker.
Come to Queensbridge, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm going to take it back. Enough respect to the projects. I'm ghost. One love. I don't know, man. That line's pretty specific. Enough respect to the projects. I'm ghost. One love. I think he's saying, you know, and right here at the end, he's calling out all these different guys. One time for your motherfucking mind. This goes out to everybody in New York that's still living the real life in the projects. All over. Yeah. I'm ghost. One love. So he's not there anymore. He's not living that life anymore, but he still has a lot of love for everybody who's still living in that life. That's how I take that. That's how I take it. And, you know, represent is all pretty clear. Okay. Well, there's one more track, track 10, It Ain't Hard to Tell. Every beat on this album has just been super easy to nod to. Just fucking rock solid. This one's actually a little bit busier than the others have been too.
I attract clientele. My mic check is life or death, breathing a sniper's breath. I exhale the yellow smoke of Buddha through righteous steps, deep like the shining. Sparkle like a diamond, sneaker Uzi on an Allen, and my army jacket lining hit the earth like a comet invasion. Nazis like the Afrocentric Asian, half man, half amazing. Cause in my physical, I can't express through song. Delete stress like Motrin, then extend strong. I drink my wet with Medusa, give a shotguns in hell. From the spliff that I lift in hell, it ain't hard to tell.
Great transition out of there into the, I guess this would be like the musical bridge, I'm not sure. Give her shotguns in hell. So shotgun is to inhale from a pipe or other smoking device. Okay. In Greek myth, man. You know, I'm still very torn about these annotations because sometimes it is interesting to read, but then they go on and on and I'm like, I can't sit here and read this during a reaction because it makes for very boring content in my opinion. Delete stress like Motrin. I like that line. I also like the idea of sneaking an Uzi in through his army jacket lining. It's pretty good. You know, it's the final track. Well, I can't do final thoughts yet. Two more minutes, I'll be doing final thoughts. But, Good stuff. Good stuff.
Loot up, parties are shoot up, Nas are analyzed, drop a jewel, inhale from the L, school of full well, you feel it like Grell, it ain't hard to tell, I keep a skill like Shaquille holds a pill, vocabulary spills, I'm ill, plasmatic, I freak beat, slam it like Iron Sheik, jam like a tech with correct techniques, so analyze me, surprise me, but can't magmatize me, scanning while you're planning ways to sabotage me, I leave a froze like heroin in your nose, Nas a rock well, it ain't hard to tell.
This is a good jam too, man. Again, Nas is just fucking solid. I like using the analogy of a quarterback in the pocket and all this chaos is going on around him and he's just chilling. Just, nope, just, I'm fine. All the shit can exist around me and I'm fine.
This rhythmatic explosion is what your frame of mind is chosen. I leave your brain stimulated. Niggas is frozen. Speak with criminal slang. Begin like a violin. End like Neviathan is deep. Well, let me try again. Wisdom be leaking out my grapefruit troop. I dominate break loops. Giving Mike's ministry cycles. Streets disciple. I rock beats this mega trifle. And groove even smoother than moves by Villanova. You're still a soldier. I'm like Sly Stone and Cobra. Packing like a roster in the weed spot. Vocals are squeezed. Glocks and CZs drop. Though they need not to sneak. My poetry's deep. I never fell. Nas's rap should be locked in a cell. It ain't hard to tell.
Well, there we go. There's Illmatic. You know, 2 minutes ago I was like, oh, I've got these things I want to say. And of course now I don't remember what I wanted to say. The first thing that comes to mind is I noticed really throughout, I didn't mention a whole lot when it comes to the music and the beats and stuff like that, because I feel for the most part, compared to the music that is more modern day, this is all kind of stripped down, a little bit more basic, a little bit more simplified, less busy, which is good. What's really striking me now, man, and I apologize, you know, I can be open with you guys, which I really appreciate, but at the same time, I don't want to spend a lot of time just unpacking all my personal shit, even though maybe it's a positive thing. I don't know. this is a 10-track album. Every fucking song was easy to listen to for me. Easy to listen to. And I just wonder, I mean, I keep thinking back, what was the deal? What was the block in my mind that prevented me from just hearing this? And I don't know. I wish there was an answer for that. And that's something I'm going to be digging around inside of my brain for a while, trying to figure out why. Why did I ever feel like this was something I couldn't listen to, or it wasn't good, or I couldn't appreciate it as music? Like, why? Where did that come from? Why did that idea exist ever? Because I just sat here, listened to it, no problem. No problem. Fucking easy. God, last week when I did Death Grips, holy shit, man. I was like, what the fuck is going on? Now, I did get into it. I enjoyed it eventually. But those first couple of tracks, man, I was like, what? I didn't know what the hell was going on. It was wild. It was not like this. And I've said this before, I'm going to say it again. I can totally get why people just go in their car and chill to this, because I want to go in my car and chill to this and just drive around and just fucking let the beats make my head do this. Just fucking drive, do, you know? Good album. That's a good album. I mean, it's just super solid on all counts. You know, it's hard to... I don't want to like rate it, because I don't like rating things. That's not what I'm into. I like appreciating and enjoying and trying to understand the music. A rating to me isn't really relevant. I either enjoy it or I don't, and that's all that matters. But I wish I could have heard this back then. You know, I wish I could have been doing this back then, because this album is so highly regarded for good reasons. It's very understandable. But it's, you know, there's kind of like the Yeezus moment where you hear that album and go, holy shit, this is fucking really good. This is completely different. And while I won't say that this is completely different from some of the gangster rap that was kind of rolling around mid-90s, it is really good. It's really good. The lyrics that Nas uses and his style and his vocal rhythm is just fucking solid throughout. I mean, it's very consistent, very clean. He's not struggling. He's not stumbling around. Mumble. There's no mumbling. Like, it's very clear, very concise, well-written lines, some good zingers in there, great storyteller. I mean, he's really laying out the world that he lives in, where he comes from, who he represents. It's great. And it's interesting too to see how he paints his version of the city in contrast to Kendrick Lamar and Good Kid, Mad City. And obviously, you know, there's a big portion of that comes from his own perspective on New York and the life that he's in. And he seems to be a lot more engaged with, you know, what I would call the gang life or the gangster life, whatever term is appropriate there to use. Whereas Kendrick, especially Good Kid, Mad City, it seems like he's doing everything he can to dodge it. And so those two different points of view paint a completely different picture in terms of the city and how you feel about the city and what's going on in the city. Like, you know, he's into it, it seems like. And that's not really, I'm not trying to say that it's either good or bad. It just is what it is. And that perspective clearly exists on the album. The World Is Yours was good. I mean, they're all good. New York State of Mind was really good. I mean, Life's a Bitch, Halftime, Memory Lane, all these tracks are great. They're great. Great album. Yeah, really good. Really good. Illmatic. I can see why it's so appreciated. I've enjoyed it. Again, I apologize for kind of getting hung up on my own shit. I did not expect this album to kind of confront me with some of my own things from 20 years ago, 30 years ago. So it was a bit of a surprise. I'm glad it happened. I feel like I've grown maybe about that much as a person. That's a good thing. And yeah, I guess there you go, guys. Illmatic, Nas, great album. Next album after that will be Tupac, Me Against the World. Not All Eyes on Me, because that's a double disc album. That's way too long. I'm not going to do that one. But Me Against the World will be the next one. All right, y'all. Take care.